think about the electricity, it's almost always there. You use it, assume that it's going to be there. This is not because it is something simple, it's very complex. In North America, we can think about billions of the components in the power system. Also think about how do we interact as a human being with the power grid. That makes it more complex. You turn on the light, you turn it off. Actually, that is kind of interaction with the power grid. It may cause the frequency goes down a little bit, and the generator may sense it and pump more energy into the power grid. It's like it has life going up and going down during our daily life. It's like a living being. The situation awareness is mainly for the power system operator, for them to know what's happening right now, what's going to happen in the future. Because power grid is kind of has a response time, that is, it takes time to ramp up the generator. You have to let the generation know ahead of time so that they can be prepared for that. The situation awareness is critical in that perspective. Without situation awareness, a lot of power system engineers tends to be conservative. That means they want to make sure the power grid will survive any events. They try to minimize the risks there. Sometimes more conservative than necessary. That means a lot of customers will lose their power supply. On the other side, because you do not know what's going to happen, you have to do that to guarantee that power grid will survive major events there. And with my research, we are trying to provide not only the good current view, but also what's going to happen in the future. Then the power system operator can operate the system to the best operational point. That means they will keep as many as consumer as possible in their grid, and at the same time, maintain the reliability of the power grid. That is what my research is going to contribute to. My name is Ning Zhou. I'm an associate professor with the Electrical and Computer Engineering Department.